There now, Anne. But what does Titian hair mean?"
"Being interpreted, it means plain red, I guess," laughed Anne. "Titian was a very famous artist who liked to paint red-haired women."
"Did you see all the diamonds those ladies wore?" sighed Jane. "It was simply dazzling. Wouldn't you just love to be rich, girls?"
"We are rich," said Anne staunchly. "Why, we have 16 years to our credit, and we're happy as queens, and we've all got imaginations, more or less. Look at that sea, girls, all silver and shadow and visions of things not seen. We couldn't enjoy its loveliness any more if we had millions of dollars and ropes of diamonds. You wouldn't change into any of those women if you could. Would you want to be that white lace girl and wear a sour look all your life as if you'd been born turning up your nose at the world? Or the pink lady, kind and nice as she is, so stout and short that you'd really no figure at all? Or even Mrs. Evans, with that sad, sad look in her eyes? She must have been dreadfully unhappy sometimes to have such a look. You know you wouldn't, Jane Andrews."
"I don't know exactly," said Jane, unconvinced. "I think diamonds would comfort a person for a good deal."
"Well, I don't want to be any one but myself, even if I go uncomforted by diamonds all my life," declared Anne. "I'm quite content to be Anne of Green Gables with my string of pearl beads. I know Matthew gave me as much love with them as ever went into Madame the Pink Lady's jewels." End of chapter 33. Chapter 34. A Queen's Girl. The next 3 weeks were busy ones at Green Gables, for Anne was getting ready to go to Queen's, and there was much sewing to be done and many things to be talked over and arranged. Anne's outfit was ample and pretty, for Matthew saw to that, and Marilla for once made no objections whatever to anything he purchased or suggested. More, one evening she went up to the east gable with her arms full of a delicate, pale green material. "Anne, here's something for a nice light dress for you. I don't suppose you really need it, you've plenty of pretty waists, but I thought maybe you'd like something real dressy to wear if you were asked out anywhere of an evening in town, to a party or anything like that. I hear that Jane and Ruby and Josie have got evening dresses, as they call them, and I don't mean you shall be behind them. I got Mrs. Allan to help me pick it in town last week, and will get Emily Gillis to make it for you. Emily has got taste, and her fits aren't to be equaled."
"Oh, Marilla, it's just lovely," said Anne. "Thank you so much. I don't believe you ought to be so kind to me. It's making it harder every day for me to go away.